Both space agencies, NASA and ISRO, have impacted the world and opened up a whole new world in what's possible for humanity to achieve in space exploration. Welcome back to another episode of FTD Facts. My name is Leroy Kenton. So there's a lot to cover in this video, and before I do that, don't forget to leave a like on this video if you love learning about outer space and space technology. And for all of you who are new faces to FTD Facts, just go ahead and tap that subscribe button as well as hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss any future videos like this. Okay, so I'm just gonna jump right in, and first up I'm gonna start with the space agency ISRO. ISRO is the sixth largest space agency in the world, and it stands for the Indian Space Research Organization, and it was founded in August 15th, 1969, and it operates under the Department of Space, which is under the government of India. ISRO has its headquarters in Bengaluru, Karnataka, India, and its primary spaceport is the Satish Dhawan Space Center, and that's located in Andhra Pradesh, India. Spaceport can also be called a cosmodrome, and it's a site for launching or receiving spacecraft. So like similar to an airport for airplanes or a seaport for boats. In this case, it's a spaceport. Now, ISRO has a vision, and that is to harness space technology for national development while pursuing space science research and planetary exploration. And as you know, space exploration and research is quite expensive. According to the most recent estimates, ISRO has a budget of $1.6 billion US to work with, and the organization has 16,072 staff members. Moving on now to NASA. NASA is the number one largest space agency in the world, and NASA stands for the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. And NASA is an independent agency of the United States government, and it's responsible for the civilian space program as well as aeronautics, which is the science or the art involved with the study, design, and manufacturing aircrafts and aerospace research. NASA was formed on July 29th, 1958, and their headquarters is at the 2 Independence Square, better known as simply just the NASA headquarters in Washington, D.C. in the United States. NASA is led by Administrator Jim Bridenstine, and he's NASA's 13th administrator. The total employees working at NASA is 17,336, and they have a budget of $20.7 billion. And all of this is in place just to fulfill on the vision of the agency, which is, we reach for new heights and reveal the unknown for the benefit of humanity. Now that I shared all of that information, I want to get more into what these space agencies actually do. So for ISRO, its mission is clear. The main objective of ISRO is to use space technology and its application for various tasks. The Indian space program was driven by the vision of Vikram Sarabhai, and he's considered the father of the Indian space program. And he said back in the year 1969, there are some who question the relevance of space activities in the developing nation. To us, there's no ambiguity of purpose. We do not have the fantasy of competing with the economically advanced nations in the exploration of the moon or the planet or manned spaceflight. But we are convinced that if we are to play a meaningful role nationally and in the community of nations, we must be second to none in the application of advanced technologies to the real problems of man and society. Now, the ISRO's headquarters, it coordinates the programs like satellite communication, Earth observation, disaster management support, sponsored research schemes, contract management, international cooperation, safety, reliability, publications and public relations, budget and economic analysis, civil engineering, and human resource development. Now, getting into more specifics of what NASA does as an agency. So NASA operates and maintains communication satellites. It monitors and manages large portions of the International Space Station, including, you know, supplying it, experiments, astronaut health, and it trains new astronauts, and it operates and maintains satellites that monitor weather, as well as satellites that monitor the sun, stars, and nebula, CO2 atmospheric levels, as well as a whole bunch of other things having to do with space and launching stuff up there. I mean, like, listing what NASA does would take up a whole new video in and of itself. So you see, NASA is a massive organization, and they have different facilities responsible for research, construction, and communication centers, and some facilities serve more than one purpose. So now we got a bit more of an idea of what these agencies are and what they do, their size and all of that. But the question now is, how did these agencies actually get to where they are and where did they have their start? When we look at ISRO, the space research activities began in early 1960s when the Tokyo Olympics Games broadcasted live across the Pacific by the American satellite called SynComp 3. And this broadcast really demonstrated the power of communication satellites. And Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, who was at the time the director of the Physical Research Laboratory, he saw how space technologies could benefit India. So from there, he took a look and he assembled a team of brilliant scientists, as well as anthropologists and communicators and social scientists from all different parts of India to lead the Indian space program. And that's when the INCOSPAR, or the Indian National Committee for Space Research, was formed. And in the year 1967, the first experimental satellite communication Earth station, or the ESCES for short, was operationalized. And then INCOSPAR eventually grew into the Indian Space Research Organization, or ISRO, in the year 1969. Now, to establish that a satellite system can contribute to the national development, the next logical step was the Satellite Instructional Television Experiment, or SITE for short, which spells out SITE. And this was seen as the largest sociological experiment in the world during 1975 to 1976. The experiment benefited around 200,000 people, covering 2,400 different villages of 6 different states, and it transmitted programs using the American technology satellite known as the ATS-6. During this period, the first Indian spacecraft, the Aryabhata, was developed and was launched using a Soviet launcher. Now, another major landmark was the development of the first launch vehicle, the SLV-3, with a capability to place 40 kilograms in low Earth orbit, which had its first successful flight in the year 1980. And see this? It paved the way for learning about launch vehicle design for more complex missions. So that was some of the early history of ISRO, and for NASA, this began during the late 1940s. During the late 1940s, the Department of Defense pursued research and rocketry and upper atmospheric sciences as a means of assuring American leadership in technology. A major step forward came when President Dwight D. Eisenhower approved a plan to orbit a scientific satellite as part of the International Geophysical Year, or the IGY. And this was during the period of July 1st, 1957 to December 31st, 1958. This was a cooperative effort to gather scientific data about the Earth. The Soviet Union quickly followed suit, announcing their plans to orbit its own satellites. Now, the Naval Research Laboratory's Project Vanguard was chosen on the 9th of September 1955 to support the IGY effort, and the Project Vanguard got some major publicity throughout the second half of the year 1955 and 1956, but the technical demands were too much and the funding was way too small. Then a huge full-scale crisis resulted on October 4th, 1957 when the Soviets launched Sputnik 1, the world's first artificial satellite, as its entry in the IGY. More immediately, the United States launched its first Earth satellite on January 31st, 1958. The United States also began a series of scientific missions to the moon and planets in the latter parts of 1950s and the early 1960s. As a direct result of this Sputnik crisis, NASA began operations on October 1st, 1958, absorbing itself into the early National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics with its 8,000 employees, as well as an annual budget of $100 million and its major research laboratories, and it quickly incorporated other organizations into this new agency, and then NASA began to conduct space missions within months of its creation. So that was an inside look into the early history of ISRO and NASA. So since then, what were some of the major successes of these space agencies? Let's first look at NASA. So since establishment, most United States space exploration efforts have been led by NASA, including the Apollo moon landing missions, the Skylab space station, and later the space shuttle. NASA supports the International Space Station and oversees the development of the Orion multipurpose crew vehicle, the Space Launch System, and the commercial crew vehicles. Now, just looking at some more of NASA's accomplishments and successes, on May 5th, 1961, astronaut Alan Shepard became the first American in space during a 15-minute suborbital flight in his Freedom 7 Mercury capsule. capsule. On May 25th, 1961, shortly after Alan Shepard's flight, President John F. Kennedy announces America's goal to land humans on the moon before the end of the decade. On June 3rd, 1965, the first American spacewalk by Ed White testing out spacesuit technology happened. December 24th, 1968, the Apollo 8 crew saw the Earth while orbiting the moon for the first time. Probably one of the most historic events happened on July 20th, 1969. In Apollo 11, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin became the first men to walk on the moon. On August 20th and September 9th, 1975, NASA launched the first spacecraft to Mars, the Viking 1 and 2, and they became the first US mission to land safely on Mars and return images of Mars's surface. On April 25th, 1990, the Hubble Space Telescope was deployed. And then on December 5th, 2014, NASA's Orion capsule completed its first space flight test. And that's only naming a few accomplishments. Now let's see what ISRO has accomplished and succeeded at. ISRO had built India's first satellite, the Aryabhata, which was launched by the Soviet Union on April 19th, 1975. Also in the year 1980, Rohini became the first satellite to be placed in orbit by the Indian-made launch vehicle, the SLV-3. ISRO subsequently developed two other rockets, the Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, or the PSLV, for launching satellites into polar orbits, and the Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle, the GSLV, for placing satellites into geostationary orbits. These rockets have launched numerous communication satellites and Earth observation satellites, as well as several satellite navigation systems have been deployed. In January 2014, ISRO used an indigenous cryogenic engine in the GSLV D5 launch for the GSAT-14. Also, ISRO sent a lunar orbiter, the Chandrayaan-1, on October 22, 2008, and as well as a Mars orbiter on the 5th of November 2013, which entered Mars's orbit on the 24th of September 2014. And this made India the first nation to succeed on its first attempt to Mars, and ISRO the fourth space agency in the world, as well as the first space agency in Asia to reach Mars's orbit. There was also a big success on June 18, 2016, where ISRO set a record with a launch of 20 satellites in a single payload. And this included a satellite from Google. ISRO had also launched its heaviest rocket, the Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle Mark II, on June 5th, 2017, and placed a communications satellite, the GSAT-19, in orbit. With this launch, ISRO became capable of launching 4-ton heavy satellites into orbit. Now, to end off this episode, honestly, I have so much appreciation for the men and women who have contributed to space exploration in any way. Thank you, NASA. Thank you, ISRO, for your contribution. And I can't wait to see what discoveries are made next. Thank you, everyone, for learning with me. You can also follow me on social media. Those links are down below. You've been awesome, and I'll see you in another episode. Hey, all of you amazing people who made it to this end screen. Here's some playlists where you can check out more educational videos. There's videos about space as well as the world in general. And don't forget to come back here every single day to FTD Facts for more videos.